Hi guys, hope you're enjoying the React Hooks course. I thought I could show you how to use the useCallback hook in this little bonus video today. So what I've done here, I set up a really simple React app here. It's just this button that generates a random number here. And as you can see in my code here, I just have the app component and the button component, and of course the index. So what's going on here? Yeah. In our app, we're using the hooks in a functional component, just as in the course. And I created a callback for the button. So when the button is clicked, this callback is invoked. The button that receives the callback, and I also console log what's happening here. So if we start looking at the application and press the button here, you can see I console log out when I click, and I also console log if the button is rendered. So first of all, we can just Google use callback and go to the React homepage. And we have it down here. And as you can see, it returns a memorized callback. And this is because in the functional components, when you re-render the component, it renders everything again. And if we look in our code, for example, or app.js or app component, when this one re-renders, it will go through all of this code again and create the callback over and over again. And there's also many that's using inline functions here for the callback. Like so, and you do something here inside this. And this anonymous function will get recreated every time you click. So there will be a lot of these ones, and that's no good if you have a really large application. To be honest, React is a pretty good and optimized library, so you don't have to worry about this really. But there's a lot of people out there worrying about recreating functions and callback functions. So what we do in a regular class component, we can remove this one and just go back to what it was before here. And we just call the function up here instead, and then it will not get recreated every time. But that's in the class components, and they work different from the functional components. So we have to do something else here for this one to not get recreated every time. And if we read a little about the use callback hook here, pass an inline callback and an array of inputs. Use callback will return a memorized version of the callback that only changes if one of the inputs has changed. So you can kind of send in this array here, just like we did with the use effect hook. And this one will control when the callback function will renew itself. And if you don't want to renew it, just like with use effects, you can just send in an empty array. So this is useful when passing callback to optimize shell components that rely on reference equality to prevent unnecessary renders, e.g. should component update. So when this one creates a new callback on every render, even if the callback haven't changed, the shell components will think that it's a new prop that's being sent in and will re-render. And of course, you have to do something to control also what props are being sent to your component, but I'll show you that in a second. So what can we do here? Because this one is being recreated every time we click on this one, it creates a new one. So we can firstly import the use callback hook, like so, use callback. And then it is as simple as just wrapping this one like so. And we also want to pass in an empty array for this one because we're not going to need to recreate this one. We just have this use state here that's creating a random number when we click this one. So it should look the same all the time. We don't have to recreate it. So we just create this callback function once, and we do that by sending in an empty array. So if we save this one and we click, and we can see that nothing has really changed here. The callback function itself is just created once, but we can't really see it now. So we can test this one by go into our button.js file. There's also one new thing in React they call React.memo. And this one, if you use the React memo, it will make this functional component to check the props. And if the props aren't changed, it won't re-render itself. And this one, you don't have to import anything special. You just write React.memo, and you wrap your component in that one, like so. So if we click this one, you can see that we're not re-rendering the component now. And that's good, because before we had this React memo, say this one again, you can see I have this console log here. Every time the app is re-rendered, the button component also gets re-rendered. But by using the memo here, like so, we are making sure that this component will check the props before it decides if it should re-render or not. And because we use the use callback hook here, we are not recreating this one in each render. So this will work now. And as I said, there's not a lot of performance issues here, so you don't really have to do it. And that's why I didn't show this one also in the course where we create the video player, because you not need to do this in this kind of small applications. But it could be good to know what the use callback is, and now you know what it is and what you can use it for. So hope this little bonus video was worth something to you and you learned something. I also hope you enjoy my React Hooks course and that it's going great. You can also hook me up on Twitter at @WebenFalk if you want to. I started to share small code tips there, especially in React, but also other things. So this is it. I hope you enjoyed it. See you.